was a, I believe it was a, I'm not sure if it was a roadside bomb, but it was a bomb that erupted underneath one of their vehicles. I was assigned to do the story just to cover, you know, the people here. They said that, you know, they felt that it was important to show support for the troops and for the families.
I guess because I've seen it so many times, and I just thought that it was the time to do it. The phenomenon, something we feel we should do.
I think it's great that people care. I really do.
And it looks so good to see all these bridges all covered with people. Yeah.
Every overpass is like this. That's what I've been told. So.
From here to where?
That way, I guess. I don't know.
It's good, but it's sad.
Just shows you how much the Canadian people really love and respect the troops, eh? You can empathize so deeply with the families that have lost their sons and daughter. I mean, it's just, the devastation must be incredible. But my concern is that it's going to hit them later on when they get back. When they come back, because in our son at least, I'm sure the others, you can just see the pain in his eyes, and what he's been through.
We feel helpless, really. I mean, these fellas will be over there.
Once you have a child over there, it just it never goes away from you after that, right? The emotion and the everything, because you've got fear and you've got happiness at the same time, and you're supporting them, but it's just so many emotions. And it's been, some people don't understand what you're going through.
Very difficult. Every time you hear that a soldier's been killed, you just wonder if it's your son. It's hard.
With my lover.